Configurations are finally here. This has been a much requested feature. Do take note that this feature is only available to commercial and education licenses. I will give an overview of how we can use this at a component, and the assembly level. If you do not see the configure tool, you will need to go to the data panel, click on the drop down at the top left corner, and create a team. Let's create this cuboid as our first component. Begin a rectangular sketch on the top plane, and dimension the length and width. You can use your own dimensions. Extrude this to a certain height. Go to Modify, Change Parameters. Expand accordingly to show the dimensions defining this cuboid. Let's name the length, width, and height accordingly. Let's add some fillets. This will be our starting design from which we can make other configurations. Let's go to Configure. These are the list of things that you can configure. Any feature that is highlighted in blue in the timeline can be configured. From here, we can open up parameters and choose the dimensions that we want to configure. Let's choose the length and width for now. These are added in the form of columns in the configuration table. We also want to configure the extrude height, but let's take a look at another method of choosing that. Close the parameters dialog. If we click on the extrude feature in the timeline, we are provided with a list of options to configure. If we hover over the distance, we can see the height parameter that we set previously. Let's check on this. This gets added in the configuration table. Next, click on the fillet. Instead of varying the fillet size, I want to toggle it on or off. To do that, we need to configure it via its suppression. So we have selected all the features that we want to configure. Let's right-click to name our default configuration, Cuboid A. Right-click to duplicate this configuration and rename this Cuboid B. From here, we can start to vary the dimensions. For this configuration, let's suppress the fillet. What we see in the display is still cuboid A. In order to see cuboid B, simply double-click. The cuboid changes in size accordingly, and the fillets have been suppressed. Let's close the configuration table. Another way to switch the configuration is to go to the browser. Let's save this component. I'm going to create a new component in a separate file. I'll be creating a cylinder with a certain diameter and height. And I will also add a chamfer. Name the parameters accordingly. Go through the same steps to configure the diameter, height, and chamfer. Cylinder A is going to be the default cylinder. Cylinder B will have a slightly different diameter and height, and will have its chamfer suppressed. I've created a new file here, which will serve as our assembly. Let's drag the cuboid in. You will be prompted to choose which configuration you want this to be in. Let's select cuboid A. I'm going to place this without moving it. Next, drag the cylinder in. Let's choose cylinder A. I'm going to move this slightly to one side. From here, we are going to create a few different sets of assemblies. In each of these assemblies, we have the ability to configure each component individually. Go to Configure. Let's click on Cuboid A in the browser. We are provided with a list of options to configure. We want to configure the cuboid based on the work that was done at the component level. To do that, we need to check on the Insert option. Repeat the same steps for cylinder A. Let's name this assembly configuration as assembly A. Right-click to duplicate this configuration and rename this assembly B. From here, we can switch the configuration of each individual component. To activate assembly B, double-click on the configuration. We can also switch the configuration using this drop-down at the browser. So I hope that this is helpful in getting you started on creating your own configurations. I've only just started to explore this myself. So do forgive me if there are any mistakes here. I'm hoping to create more videos on more advanced configurations in the future.